It is 1 o'clock, 1:20 in the morning.
Ну а сейчас, собственно, вы увидите процедуру передачи черных ящиков в Малайзийской стране.
On behalf of the government of Malaysia, I would like to convey our sincere appreciation to His Excellency, Mr. Boronai. Priority now is first is the body, second is the black box.
В настоящий момент у нас три задачи. Это переправка.
Now they'll take those black boxes also aboard this train, the bodies of some 200 of the victims from the accident.
When it finally arrives here at the railway station, it will be met by a number of Dutch experts we've seen coming into the airport here.
In Kharkov, there will be preparations so that the identification process in the Netherlands can be done as well as possible.
Zodra een aantal slachtoffers klaar is.
As soon as a number of victims is ready for transport, a plane will leave for Eindhoven. The hope and expectation is that tomorrow, at the end of the day, the first plane will leave for Eindhoven. The phased transport of bodies will continue until all remains on the train in Kharkov arrived in the Netherlands.
Well, right now, Malaysian experts are in the field, just up the road from me here.
I'm here at one of the eight crash scenes, the biggest one. And in fact, I'm standing just a few meters away from the tail section of the aircraft that came down. And just behind it are three representatives of Malaysian Airlines who have just arrived to the site with us for the first time. We have now brought three different groups of experts. The Ukrainian experts from day one. Yesterday, the Dutch forensic experts accompanied us. And today, three Malaysian experts have accompanied us, and they have gotten in and out of this area without much trouble at all.
While we were there, you were talking about rockets in your previous segment. There was quite a bit of heavy weaponry fire in the distance. We could see a big kind of mushroom cloud, and we could definitely hear it. You can imagine the impact that had on the Malaysians.
They could smell the presence of death as they moved through the wreckage and hear the rockets falling in the distance.
Украинской, город Первомайск, Луганской области. 2:50. Летит сирена на заводе Карла Маркса. Были взрывы, третий раз заход делает, по ней отрабатывают.
Бабушка с дома!
года. Город Луганск, квартал Комарова, 32-й дом. И человек лежит.
Сходи, девушка, за булочкой хлеба. Порошенко, ты убийца, тварь. Тут двое погибших, да?
Квартал Комарова, квартира, дом 32А.
48.
48.
Пятый этаж.
Снаряд попал прямо в крышу на кухне. Держитесь, я скоро зайду к вам. Держитесь.
Вот у нас такое бомбоубежище, заходите.
Студенты и своих граждан Украины уничтожают. Самым настоящим убивают.
Не задать сейчас зайти спрашивать.
Они расстреляют людей, мирные дома.
То есть нужно разрезать их коммуникации и освободить нам коридоры, правильно?
Ну, главное просто навести порядок, чтобы у нас было меньше кровопролития.
Угу.
То есть нужно просто прекратить, чтобы меньше бомбили городами мирных жителей, города Луганск, тоже Славянск, что превратили. Нам нужно прекратить поскольку эту технику ударом туда, потому что они воюют не по правилам воинского искусства, они просто бомбят мирных жителей. То есть в открытом бою вот они не больно-то, вы видите, не больно-то, они выходят, это боль, Они только воюют по правилам американских инструкторов.
And there are also several reports that the Ukrainian military has continued to issue attacks in eastern Ukraine, despite everything going on with the investigation. What kind of information do you have on that? And has the U.S. said anything whatsoever to Kiev authorities about a ceasefire?
Well, the president of Ukraine is committed to a 40-kilometer ceasefire around the crash site, and I believe the fighting is outside of that 40 kilometers. I think he's held to it.
The Europeans today met, the European Council met, yes, and said that they were going to expand and enhance
visa bans, asset freezes. Yep.
That's correct. I presume that you think that's a good thing.
This meeting today is an opportunity for us to send a very clear signal to Russia. The world has changed since the European Council last week.
Deeply saddened by the downing of the Malaysian airliner in eastern Ukraine last Thursday, EU Foreign Affairs Ministers meeting today in Brussels welcomed the unanimous adoption of the UN Security Council resolution.
We today decided to accelerate the preparation of targeted measures agreed at the summit last week. In particular, to put in place very quickly a list of entities and people, including from Russia, under the new enhanced criteria.
Now we are in a completely different dimension.
As far as we are concerned, something fundamental has changed since last Thursday.
En wat Nederland betreft,
and as far as the Netherlands is concerned, all options are now on the table.
Does Ukraine's government feel shared responsibility because of the ongoing conflict and what the militiamen say is constant attacks of eastern towns? Do you believe you share responsibility for creating an atmosphere of violence that led to the shooting down of the plane?
Not at all.
Вчера, когда ополченцы передавали так называемые черные ящики, вооруженные силы Украины устроили танковую атаку на город Донецк. Нужно в конце концов призвать и киевские власти к соблюдению элементарных норм порядочности, ввести хотя бы на какое-то короткое время для расследования прекращения огня.
My government will do everything for peace. For peace and stability. But to get peace, you have to fight. This is the formula.